Request today's coordinator, Srimati A. Karunasri, you please start day two session for STTP on soft skills.
Thank you, sir. Good morning, everyone. On behalf of Balaji Fraternity, I, A. Karunasri, coordinator of this program, genially welcome Principal of Balaji Institute of Technology and Science, Dr. V.S. Hariharan, sir. Dr. V. Narayana, Head of Humanities and Sciences Department and today's program convener. Today's chief guest resource person, Sister Kalpana Madam, Dr. V. Sudhakar Rao, sir, advisor of our department, Mr. A. Srinivas, co-coordinator, heads of the departments, faculty friends, and all the participants for the second day session of a short-term training program on propositions of soft skills and their relevances to life and academics. This STTP is being organized by Department of English from Humanities and Sciences. So this second day session is on the topic entitled Positive Reflections. Before welcoming our today's resource person, let me feel privileged to introduce Sister Kalpana. Sister Kalpana has pursued our MSc Environmental Science at Kakatiya University and MSc Value Education and Spirituality at Annamalai University. To speak about our spiritual journey, she is the practitioner of Brahma Kumari's Raja Yoga meditation since childhood. She started serving as Raja Yoga meditation trainer in Brahma Kumari's organization since 1998. And currently, she has been rendering her services as the coordinator of Brahma Kumari's at Narsampet Division. Kalpana sister is a Raja Yoga meditation trainer and motivational speaker, conducting varied variety of programs for the management personnel at different institutions. She is creative in nature, and her messages are simple, meaningful, and reveal divine versions of God. She has delivered more than 500 lectures on stress management, self-managing, leadership, memory development, education in values and spirituality, thought power, positive lifestyle, communication skills, and many more. Madam, really, we are very much pleasure to have you, madam. Now, I request Kalpana sister to proceed to the second day session. Over to you, madam.
Om Shanti. Mm-hmm. A very pleasant morning to all of you. First of all, let me express my gratitude and greetings of peace to Dr. Rajendra Prasad Reddy Garu, Chairman Balaji Group of Institutions, Dr. Rajeshwar Reddy Garu, Secretary Balaji Group of Institutions, Dr. Hariharan Sir, Principal BITS, and Coordinators Sudhakar Rao Sir and Karunasri Madam, and Narayana Sir, HOD Humanities. I really appreciate the wonderful services being organized by Balaji Group of Institutions, especially during this Corona crisis lockdown period. And I express my heartfelt thanks on behalf of Brahma Kumari's organization to Dr. Rajendra Prasad Reddy Garu. He is a man with a visionary mission, and he is dynamic. And through his educational institutions, he is serving the society in a very great manner. And really, Balaji Group of Institutions, they own a very remarkable place, especially in the field of education in Warangal district. So I feel very privileged to be a part of your program. So in connection with Engineers Day, we are conducting this program through BITS. So first of all, I would like to express my greetings of belated Happy Engineers Day to all of you. So yesterday also, Professor Hari Krishna Garu, he has enlightened us in a beautiful manner about human values and professional ethics. So today, as a part of this program, let us interact on soft skills, positive reflections. We all know that performing any task, we may do a particular task in two ways. So PPT is visible?
Yes, sister, it is visible. You press F5, sister. That is better.
So in order to do a particular work, we can do any work in a, either in a simple way or in a skillful way. Definitely, we see a lot of difference in these two ways. So what are skills? Skills are the expertise or the talents which are needed to do a particular job. So work skills. When we are speaking about work skills, here we have two skills, hard skills and soft skills. Hard skills. Hard skills, these are the physical skills or the concrete skills which are very, very essential to do a particular work. For example, if a person is a computer programmer, then definitely coding would be his hard skill. If a person is a chef, then definitely cooking would be his hard skill. When speaking to soft skills, they are the personal attributes of a person that support us in situational awareness. And these skills, they enhance an individual's ability to get a job done. So both soft skills and hard skills, they are important, and a person need to access himself with these two skills in order to become more hireable and more successful in life. But we see some differences in these two skills. Hard skills, we can learn these hard skills from schooling, through our trainings and through past working experiences. Whereas soft skills, they are a bit difficult to learn. And hard skills, once you are habituated, once you learn the technique, then definitely you will possess that skill. Whereas soft skills, we develop these soft skills when we interact with people. And these soft skills define us, how we are relating with people and how we are relating with work and life. So these soft skills we can develop only when we come in contact with people in real work, then only we can develop. And hard skills, we can measure these hard skills through our education, through certifications, and through trainings, through past life experience, past work experiences. Whereas soft skills, they are a bit harder to measure. We can't easily evaluate these soft skills. So both these hard skills and soft skills are needed. So today, in connection with Engineers Day, we are conducting this program. So I remember Sir Moksha Gundam Vishweshwaraya Garu, who is a very good example of possessing both hard skills and soft skills. He was a very good civil engineer, very expertise civil engineer, and he has contributed his engineering skills in construction of various projects, dams in different states of India. So along with engineering skills, he also possessed soft skills such as perseverance, decision making, his accountability, punctuality. So therefore, even till today, we are remembering him and we are celebrating his birthday as National Engineers Day. So these skills, they are very, very important to each and everyone. And these skills, they are important, they are essential in every aspect of our life. We can even call these skills as life skills. We can even call these skills as life skills. And these life skills, sir, video is not visible. Sir, video is visible.
Video is not visible, ma'am. You want to play video, sister? Screen is, presentation is okay, sister. It is visible.
Presentation is visible.
Yes. Slides are visible, sister.
Slides are visible. Okay. My voice is also audible.
Yes, no? Perfect, sister. Yes.
So in this way, life, these are called as life skills, and they are very, very essential in every aspect of our life. So life skills, they include clear communication. So communication is needed at each and every step. Listening skills, from the childhood, we are very much habituated to how to speak. We are often taught how to listen. So listening is also very, very essential. Therefore, it is said that God has given us 2 ears and 1 mouth. We have to listen more and we have to speak less. But coming to reality, it becomes quite opposite. So self-controlling, so controlling of our emotions is also very, very needed. And positive attitude, which we are going to discuss, interact today. Assertiveness, that is being firm in our principles and standards, it is also very, very important. And conflict resolution, whenever we across any conflict, how to resolve it in our, from our side, it is also very important. And empathy, feeling as other person suffering as mine and understanding them from their point of view is also very, very important. And feeling depersonalization and responsibility and a sense of humor. So these all come under life skills. And these life skills, they are also said to be soft skills. And today we are going to interact about one of these soft skills, that is how to think in a positive manner. Because positive thinking is also a greatest, is also an important soft skill. So let us all cultivate these skills along with hard skills. So positive thinking. Today we are familiar with this word, positive thinking. So many people, they even write as a quotation also, be positive, think positive. But very few people know actually what is meant by positive thinking and how to inculcate this positive thinking and how to practice this in our day-to-day life. So today, let us understand briefly regarding positivity. How can we think in a positive manner? So when we are speaking about thoughts, positive thinking, positive thoughts, so let us first of all understand what is the role of thoughts. Because when we are speaking about thoughts, they thoughts are the seed of our life. They are the seeds of our life's tree. So have you thought any thought of your thought? Do you know actually what is the faculty which is thinking? We produce n number of thoughts throughout the day. So for this, to understand clearly about thoughts, let us understand the faculty actually which is producing these thoughts. Because since childhood, we have been taught how to do. But no one has taught us how to be. Even if anyone has taught us how to be, it was just how to speak and how to talk. But no one has ever taught us how to think. So today, let us understand from a new perspective the new art of thinking in a positive way. So for this, let us understand the role of thoughts. Actually, what are thoughts? In what way they contribute? Let us understand about thoughts. So thoughts, they are the core thing of our life. They are the seeds. And so if we pay attention at the seed level, then definitely the outcome will be very good. And if we don't pay attention at the seeds level, then definitely we have to bother by its outcome. So let us understand clearly about thoughts. For example, an engineer, first of all, he thinks about a plan for a building, and that thoughts, then he put in on a paper, and that then ultimately it comes into a concrete building. So if we want to get good outcomes, then definitely we have to nurture ourselves with good thoughts. So therefore, thoughts are said to be seeds of our life's tree. So as the saying goes, we shall reap what we sow. What we sow shall we reap. So therefore, let us be careful, let us be cautious at the level of thoughts itself. So the thinking faculty of the soul, because we all are spiritual beings, and we spiritual beings, we possess this physical body, and this physical body, it is run by the spiritual entity which is present in this body. We call it as Atma or soul, life energy, life force, psyche, ruh, in different with different names. And this Atma, this soul, it comprises of mind, intellect, and sanskaras. Mind, intellect, and personality traits. Here I remember former President Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. His famous book, Ignited Mind is the Greatest Resource on This Earth. And I remember great lines of that book. Think, think, think. Imagine, imagine, imagine. Act, act, act. So when thinking and action, they both go together, then a person can do wonders. So mind, which is the thinking faculty, it thinks, it generates thoughts, it desires, it remembers, it feels. And intellect is the decision-making faculty. It discriminates, it judges, it decides. And personality traits, when the thoughts generated by the mind and processed by the intellect, when they are put into action, the imprints which we develop, they ultimately result to our habits. So therefore, if we want to think in a positive way, we should have a clear idea about the faculty which is thinking. Therefore, it is said, watch your thoughts because they become your words. Watch your words and they become your actions. Watch your actions, they become your habits. Watch your habits, they become your character. And watch your character, it becomes your destiny. So when we are careful at the thought level, then definitely we'll get good results in action level also. So therefore, the quality of thoughts result in quality of actions. The quality of thoughts, they lead to quality of our feelings. So therefore, quality of our thoughts is very, very essential. So on an average, our mind produces 15 to 25 thoughts. And these thoughts, they are of different types. Ordinary thoughts, positive thoughts, negative thoughts, and waste thoughts. In this way, we categorize our thoughts into these four types. Ordinary, these are the ordinary thoughts which we generate on our day-to-day activities in our regular routines. They are non-productive, they are and positive thoughts. Positive thoughts, these are the thoughts which are related with our success, which are related with our health, with our achievements, with our accomplishments. And negative thoughts, these thoughts which are related with sorrowful events, sad feelings, which are related with anger, hatredness, and waste thoughts. The word waste itself indicates they are of no use, they are non-productive thoughts. So in this way, throughout the day, we produce number of thoughts, and all these thoughts may be categorized into these four types. So among these four types, now today, let us discuss, let us interact on positive thinking. Positive thinking. So what is positive thinking? Nowadays, we are very scared by listening the word positive because the corona crisis is going on, and if at all a person listens to corona positive, we are very much scared, but no need to bother. This is related with our thoughts. So we should be, we are expecting corona negative, but while thinking, we have to be positive. So positive thinking in a simple way means having a good look at yourself. We need to have a very good look towards ourselves. Positive thinking means it is a mental and emotional attitude that focuses on the bright side of life and expects positive results. Positive thinking actually means approaching life's challenges with a positive outlook. Actually, we are fundamentally positive. Positivity is hidden within us. And we have a greatest resource within ourselves. But we are trapped in the negative feelings. We are trapped. We are totally engulfed ourselves in the negative feelings and negative thoughts and negative emotions. Therefore, we feel very hard to generate positive thoughts. Once, a sculptor, he was making very good idols out of stone. So a person asked him, how could you are able to prepare such good idols out of that stone? And this sculptor, he replies, I need not to do anything. The beauty is already hidden in that stone. I just remove the extra stone in that particular stone, he says. So in the same way, we are fundamentally positive. Positivity is hidden in us. But since we are totally filled with negative emotions and negative thinking all around us, we are unable to think in a positive manner. So it is said that nothing is really good or bad. Only thinking makes it so. So thinking is the most subtle form of action. So few people, they have a doubt. Why we have to think in a positive way? What is the use of thinking in a positive way? Why we have to think in a positive way means positive thinking, it helps us in many ways. When a person does positive thoughts, this positive thinking, it helps us to gain energy to our mind, and our mind becomes our best friend. And by doing positive thinking only, we can create a favorable inner environment. And by doing positive thinking, we can develop our self-esteem. So in this way, positive thinking always leads us towards positive actions only. So let us clearly understand this by the cycle of positive thoughts. When a person starts producing positive thoughts, if a student thinks in a positive manner, if he feels, I am good enough, I will pass my test. So in this way, if we generate these type of thoughts, then definitely he starts feeling himself, he starts imagining himself, he is passing the exam. So thoughts leads to feelings, and those feelings definitely recollects with the past successful incidents, and he remembers those situations, and he can develop confidence within himself, and he can take test with confidence, and ultimately he will pass the exam, and he can have a proof of the passing of that exam. So in this way, this is the cycle of positive thoughts. When I generate positive thoughts, then my feelings go as per, and I generate such level of confidence, then I put it into practice, then definitely I'll be with positive results. So in the same way, when a person does negative thoughts, if a person thinks in a negative manner, I'm not good enough to communicate with you all, I'm not good enough in my academics. So in this way, if a student starts thinking in such a way, then definitely the thought which arises in his mind is, I will fail my test. And he imagines himself failing the test. And he remembers other situations of failure which occurred in his life previously. And then automatically he develops fear. He feels insecure. And he takes test with that fear only. And he ultimately he sees failure, and he'll get the proof of his failure. So in this way, cycle of positivity and cycle of negativity shows us it all starts with a single thought. So if we start with a single thought of positivity, then definitely the result will be in a positive manner. If we start with a single thought of negativity, then the result will be in a negative manner. Because a positive person, he always sees the brighter side of anything. And a negative person, he always sees the darker side of anything. A positive person, he always sees the best in everything. Whereas a negative person, he sees worst in everything. A positive person always sees everything as an opportunity. Whereas a negative person, he sees everything as a repentance. He always repents from the past experience. And a positive person always presents himself with zeal and enthusiasm. Whereas a negative person, he is always in disappointment. He is always in repentance. So therefore, always we should try to be positive in our thinking and positive in our activities. So now let us understand it more clearly. Because whenever we perform a work, we have two choices. We have to remember this. We have a choice while performing every task. We have a choice. Either we can think in a positive way or we can think in a negative way. So every time we have a choice. Once, two salesmen were sent to an African country from a shoe manufacturing company. They want to discover new markets in that area. So these two salesmen, they were sent to African country, and they stayed there. They studied about the living culture of the people there. They stayed there for a couple of weeks, and they have returned with their findings, and they produced their findings in the form of a report to their manager. The first salesman, he gave a report. He said, "Sir, I have observed everything, and out of my observation, I came to know that there is no market in that country because I haven't seen anyone wearing shoes there." So in this way, he gave the report as no market. And the second salesman, he also gave his report. He gave the report as, "Sir, there is a scope for full market. I have stayed there and studied the lifestyle of people there. Haven't seen anyone wearing shoes there, but there is still scope for our shoes, a full market." So in this way, he reported. See, both these two salesmen, They went to the same African country and they have stayed there, and they did their observation there, studied the people, and these two people, they came with different conclusions. Though both have the same observation, but came up with different conclusions. One is saying there is no market, and the other one is saying there is full market. See, so in this way, at every step of our life, we have two choices. So whether we think in a positive way or we think in a negative way. So every time we have two choices. So it's up to us, which one do we select? Whether we think in a positive way or we think in a negative way. So if at all a person faces any situation, then definitely he has two choices. Likewise, one, we can react in a negative manner, and other, we can respond in a positive manner. So always we have these two choices. We may react in a negative manner, or we may respond in a positive manner. So let us understand this clearly by an example. Once a famous writer, he wrote on a piece of paper and kept on the table. He wrote on that piece of paper, "During the recent times, I have underwent a major surgery of gallbladder infection. So it gave me much pain. And during these days, I got retirement from my job. And during this period only, I have lost my father. And these are all the sorrowful incidents which I have faced during this period. And in spite of all these adverse situations, my son has met with an accident. So in this way, totally these days are very, very sorrowful to me. And these days are very bad to me. So in this way, he has written on a piece of paper. Then after a few hours, his wife entered into the room. And she has studied writings on the piece of paper, and she has written besides that in this manner: "After your years of suffering from gallbladder infection, you got relief from that pain by this surgery. And after your busy schedule, through your job, now you got enough time to spend for your passion. Your father has been expired at the age of 88 with good health and without depending on anyone. Thank God, though our son has met with an accident, but he's alive and God has blessed him a new life." See, same situation, but see the responses, the reactions of two people in different ways. Husband reacted in a negative way, whereas wife responded in a positive way. So in the same manner, in our life also, we may face so many situations, we may come across so many circumstances, but every time we have choice of responding in a positive manner or reacting in a negative manner. So we have to choose. So though the situation is same, two people's reactions, their responses are totally different. So if we want to respond in a positive manner, we need to think in a positive way. We need to perceive the situation in a positive way. We need to change our outlook and consider the situation from a positive perspective. Then only we can give positive response. So therefore, at every step, the choice is ours. We have two choices, whether to react negatively or to respond positively. So it is up to us how we choose, which choice we choose. But changing our perspective from negative to positive is also very, very important. Unless and until we change our perspective from negative to positive, we are unable to enjoy every moment of life. We are unable to get the expected results in our life. So therefore, changing our perspective from negative to positive is also very, very essential. So how we can change our perspective? Because always we are, a person is influenced by the circumstances, possessions, people, and when we start thinking in a positive way, we try to choose our response. How I should respond towards this situation. And when I choose my response, then my state of mind depends upon what others say and do becomes, I create my state of mind. So instead of depending on others' words, I create my state of mind and others also respond accordingly. So therefore, changing our perspective from negative to positive is also very, very essential. Because in life, always situations may not work in the desirable way we are expecting. So therefore, sometimes we cannot change the situations. The only thing we can change is we can change our perspective from negative to positive. I heard one lecturer sharing his personal experience regarding how he has changed his perspective from negative to positive in his working area. So their college was situated near a railway track. He was serving in a vocational training college, and every time whenever this lecturer's period was there, and at that time only two trains used to go, and there was a lot of disturbance during his period only. So this lecturer as well as students all got very much disturbed, and students are not at all interested to join this lecturer's period. So this lecturer also felt very sad, very bad, and he approached the authorities of college and he complained to change his period. And they said, as per our schedule, this is the available time, available period for you. You have to go with this only. So he tried to change his perspective. He started thinking in a new way. He told the students that whenever you hear a train sound, you try to laugh. And all the students, whenever they are going to hear a train sound, they started laughing. And on the next day, he said, whenever you hear a train sound, you please clap. And students were with so much joy and enthusiasm, they started clapping by hearing the train sound. And on the next day, he said, whenever you hear a train sound, you start singing. And students felt very joy, and they started singing by hearing the train sound. And on the other day, he said, whenever you hear a train sound, you please start dancing. And students start dancing. So in this way, this lecturer has found that students slowly they developed interest in his period, interest in his subject. And he was able to see the percentage of attendance of the students has also increased. So why we are quoting this example here means some situations in our life we cannot change. So the only thing we can change is we have to change our perspective. We have to change the way we approach towards the situations. So by changing that perspective, that lecturer, he could able to create interest among students, and he was able to enjoy that period, and he was able to go through that period in spite of train sound. So in this way, if we want to think in a positive way, if we want to be a positive thinker, we need to change our perspective from negative to positive, because this positive thinking, it acts as a first aid to our life, and through this positive thinking only we gain, our mind gains energy. Positive thoughts, they give nourishment to our mind. They are like good food to our mind. So positive thoughts are very, very essential, and positive thoughts only, they lead to positive actions. So what are positive thoughts? The three simple positive thoughts are, I can, I must, I will. Yes, I did it. Yes, I can. So these are the positive thoughts which lead us to positive actions. So therefore, we should always try to think in a positive manner, because as is the quality of our thoughts, so will be the quality of our feelings. As is the quality of our feelings, so will be the quality of our habit, actions, habit, etc. So therefore, we have to improve ourselves at the level of thinking only, at the level of thoughts itself. So therefore, always think in a positive way. So what are the positive thoughts? I can, I must, I will. Whereas negative thoughts means, can I can't, I don't, I won't. So saddest words we often use, if only I had given a little extra, I should have, I could have, I wish I had, it might had been. So these are the words, instead of positivity, we use these words. So if we want to develop ourselves in a positive manner, so positive thinking is also associated with positive mindset. So how we can develop this positive mindset? So it is based on few characteristics. These characteristics are such as optimism, acceptance, resilience, gratitude, mindfulness, integrity with self-esteem. So these are the different characteristics which are associated with positive mindset. So if we want to be a positive thinker, if we want to reflect on ourselves in a positive manner, definitely we have to imbibe these attributes also. Definitely we have to inculcate these qualities also. So optimism. Optimism means it is always looking at the brighter side of anything. It is always looking at the bright side of anything. We generally think that dark is the opposite of brightness, but dark is not the opposite of brightness, or light is the opposite of dark. Dark is just absence of light. So in the same way, we think that problems are of absence of solution. Problems are not absence of solution. Problems are absence of an idea. So therefore, we need to consider always that there is a brighter side. Tomorrow I will achieve it. Tomorrow there is a hope. So optimism means always striving towards better tomorrow with a new hope. Because positive thinking means always thinking in a new way. When we explain about water filled in a glass, which is up to half level only, but a optimistic person expresses it as it is half filled, whereas a pessimistic person, he expresses it is half empty. So if we want to be a positive thinker, always look into the half filled side, because if we look at the half empty side, we are unable to enjoy the filled part. We are unable to get ourselves access with the filled part. Once two friends, they were watching a view from the window, from their room. One friend, he was narrating about the beauty of a lotus flower, which is in the muddy water. And the other friend, He is also viewing from the same window, and he is narrating the scars on moon, on full moon day. See, both of them, though they are viewing from the same window, based on their mindset, one is optimistic and one is pessimistic. One is seeing the beauty of lotus in being in the muddy water, and one is narrating the scars on moon on full moon day. So in the same way, life also appears to us. So therefore, always think in a optimistic way. Always our approach should be in a optimistic way. And second characteristic includes acceptance. Positive thinking doesn't mean always we should expect the best, expecting good only, but it also means that accepting whatever the result we get and considering it as the best for the present moment. So accepting the result and doing our best, and to do, and again trying to do best. But if we want to do again best, we need to accept the present result. Unless and until we accept the present result, we are unable to present ourselves in an improved manner for better results. So therefore, accept the present and do best for next, trying for next. So here I want to quote an example of Dadarao Bilhore, famously known as Pothole Dada of Mumbai. During the year 2015, he was an ordinary person. He lost his son in a road accident in rainy season due to the depressions on the surface of the roads. So his 16-year-old son he lost, and this was irreplaceable for him in his life. He wept, he felt very sorrow, and later on he accepted the situation and he accepted the present fact, and he started thinking in a new way. He started a journey. Anyhow, I have lost my son, and this loss to me is irreplaceable. So I don't let any other son to meet again with an accident due to the depressions on the surface of the road. So I'll try my level best to fulfill it. So in this way, he started his journey. Daily, he carries some graveled material, some broken paver blocks, and a shovel. And he goes to different areas, and he fills the depressions on the surface of the roads in Mumbai. And from 2015 till date, he was able to fill 600 potholes in Mumbai. Therefore, he is famously known as Pothole Dada of Mumbai. And he shares his experience that whenever, wherever I fill a pothole with graveled material, graveled stones, I feel as if I am offering Shraddhanjali to my son. So see the great thinking of that Dadarao Bilhore. Means he accepted the situation, he stood strong, and he started trying for the next moment. So in this way, we need to accept the situation, we need to move forward, because life is like a flowing river. A river has so many turns. In the same way, life also shows us, gives us so many unexpected turns, and we don't know how they will be. Maybe some are good and some are bad, but we need to enjoy our life at every turn, because these turns, they may not return again in our life. So therefore, acceptance is very, very essential to be positive. And after accepting the situation, resilience is also very important. Resilience means it is not looking back, it is moving forward. never give up. Always we should place ourselves on our own feet. We should place always ourselves on our own feet. So never give up. This is just like bouncing back. Whenever you fall down, again you should try to get up, bounce back to achieve your goals, to fulfill your dreams, to have good accomplishments in your life. So we have so many lively examples for this resilience. This Brahma Kumaris organization, it has been started as a small family organization past 80 years ago. And during this journey, this organization has faced so many hardships, so many hurdles. The patrons of Brahma Kumaris, the fraternity of Brahma Kumari, they have faced so many problems, so many hardships. And in spite of those all hardships, today this Brahma Kumaris organization has moved, it has paved its way in all the five continents. And this organization's branches are spread over in about 147 countries. So it has, though it has faced so much of opposition from different cultural areas, but it was able to survive. And today, this Brahma Kumaris organization is one of the greatest spiritual organization, which is totally run by women, which is a practical example for women empowerment also. So even though it has faced so many hardships, we are able to move forward, and today we are seeing the greatest glory of this organization. And we have so many other examples also in society. I want to quote the example of Benno Jeffin. Benno Jeffin was the first Indian foreign service officer. She was the first Indian foreign service officer, women officer, with 100% visually challenging ability. She was 100% visually challenged. From the childhood only, she was 100% visually challenged. In the early age only, at the very young age only, Benno Jeffin, she made up of a strong belief in her mind that this disability, it doesn't matter. This disability is just a state of mind. It has nothing to do in achieving my goal. In no way it can interrupt in my achievements. So in this way, she made a very strong belief at the very early age, and she could strive very hardly. She didn't have enough material in Braille Lipi, but in spite of that, she could achieve UPSC rank, and she was posted as a Indian Foreign Service officer. So in this way, in spite of hardships, they never give up, they bounce back, and they could achieve their accomplishments. Mary Combe. We are familiar with Mary Combe. She is known as Magnificent Mary. She is one of the greatest boxers across the country, and she won 5 medals, one bronze medal in 2012 in London Olympics, and in 2014 she won gold medal in Asian Games. So in spite of her hardships, in spite of her circumstances, she could able to move forward, and she was able to change her perception, and she juggled between motherhood and her dreams, and she was able to achieve her dream. So in this way, we have so many live examples. Arunima Sinha also, first Indian woman amputee to climb Mount Everest in spite of different things which occurred in her life. She was thrown from a running train, but being on the bed at the hospital, she made in her mind, with this amputee leg only, I will climb Mount Everest. So in this way, she was able to climb not only Mount Everest, Kilimanjaro also. So we have so many examples. The persons who, in spite of their hardships, in spite of their adverse situations, they could move forward, they kept on growing, they kept on trying, they could achieve their goals, they could fulfill their dreams. So in this way, we should be resilient to be positive. And to practice positive thinking, attitude of gratitude is also very, very important. Once a professor, he entered the class and he announced to all the students, "Now I am going to take a small test, surprise test. Are you ready?" Then students were also very anxious what would come up in the test. So they were very anxious, and that professor, he distributed a question paper facing it down. And when he distributed that question paper to all the students, he requested them to turn backside and start answering the question. But out of surprise, students were in a confusion state. They were seeing with a confusion mood towards the professor. On that, when they turned the paper, they couldn't see any question in the paper. They were able to see only a black dot on that paper, on that white paper. They were all surprised. Then sir said, "Anyhow, you are going to answer this question. Your question is what you are able to see on this paper." And students, though they don't have any choice, they started writing the question, and they wrote it well, and everyone handed over the answer sheet to the professor. And after that, professor started reading out loudly each and every person's answers. So everyone narrated about the black dot, the size of the dot, the color of the dot, and its structure. So in this way, almost all the students, they were able to write about the black dot only. So professor, he said, "Anyhow, no one is going to get any marks from this test. You are not going to get any grade out of this test, because I expected something different from you. I expected you students to ponder on something, but you couldn't. You were all focused your attention to on that black dot only, and you narrated about that black dot only in spite of the white paper. You can absorb so much from that white paper. You can learn so much from that white paper, but you are all focused on that black dot only." So in the same way, in our lives also, we have so much to feel thankful. We have so much to feel, to be grateful, but we always focus our attention on that black dots only. I have this, I have that, I have this problem, I have that problem with that person. So in this way, we are always habituated to narrate about our problems. We are unable to see the total white paper. We are able to see only that black dots. But we have to make an habit. We have to make a habit of gratitude, attitude of gratitude, because there are so many things in our life, in our lives. In spite of those black dots, we have so many people around us to feel thankful, to be grateful. So we should be thankful to nature. Nature has given us with so many resources. It has given us with so much of beauty. We have to enjoy it. We should be thankful to nature, and we should be thankful to God. God has given us so much in this life. We should be thankful to our parents, our siblings, and our family members. We should be thankful to all the persons who are rendering their services at their disposal, whoever is helping us in our life, who are serving us. So in this way, we should feel gratitude. We should feel grateful towards all the people around us. We should always count on our blessings. instead of pondering on our curses. So when we have the attitude of gratitude, then only we could develop positive mindset. And one more characteristics which is associated with positive mindset is mindfulness. We should always live in the present. We should always enjoy the present moment, because most of the time people they pass on their time by repenting on the past or unnecessarily planning on the future, worried planning on the future. So therefore it is said we should learn from yesterday and live in today and plan for tomorrow, hope for tomorrow. Learn from yesterday, live in today and hope for tomorrow. So therefore whatever work we are doing with so much of mindfulness, with so much of zeal and enthusiasm, we have to do. We have to focus our mind in present day on present work, then only we'll feel happy. So when we focus our mind on the present work, then we'll definitely get good outcome. We all know the example of digging gold. In gold mines, when they go for gold mining, to get an ounce of gold, they have to remove tons of dust, mud, etc. But they don't feel bad of this mud or dust. They were totally focused on the ounce of gold only. So in the same way, we have to focus ourselves in our life towards our goals, towards our dreams, towards our accomplishments, in spite of many hardships and adverse conditions. And integrity is also very, very essential. Integrity of self-esteem. A positive self-esteem with integrity. Integrity means you are whole and undivided. You are firm in your principles. You are very righteous, honorable. So integrity of our thoughts, integrity of our actions is also very, very essential. For this, we need to have a very good self-esteem. Once a person was washing his new car and a neighbor from the next house, he came there and he was asking this person, when did you get this new car? When did you buy this new car? And this person replies, I got this new car from my brother. He gifted me this new car on this festival. So I am gifted this new car from my brother. And this neighbor also starts thinking, I wish I had a car like this. And this person says, you should wish you should have a brother like mine. And the neighbor's wife was listening to the whole conversation, and she interrupts and she replies, I wish I am a brother like yours. So see the self-esteem of that neighbor's wife. So in the same way, if we want to be positive, we should always have a very good self-esteem. So how to develop positive thinking? So by three steps, we are going to develop positive thoughts, positive thinking. Stand back, observe, steer up. So stand back. For this, we need to separate ourselves from the influence of our mind and from our thoughts. Stand back. You need to stand back and create a space for yourself. And you need to think. You need to think how your thoughts are produced in your mind. And then observe how your mind is thinking, in what way it is perceiving the situations, how it is influenced, then steer up. So By this method, we can develop the technique of thinking in a positive way. So stand back, create a space and remind to yourself, problems don't last forever. Definitely tomorrow holds a solution. Standing back clears my mind to see a solution. Standing back clears my mind to see a solution. So if we want to develop positive thinking, suddenly we can't develop. It needs a lot of practice and it needs a lot of reflections to always ponder over. So by this technique, we can develop positive thinking, stand back, observe and steer up. So sit calmly, create a space for yourself and detach yourself from the influence of your thoughts and remind yourself that whatever problems I'm having, they don't last forever. Tomorrow definitely holds a solution. And observe, what is influencing me? Whether my own thoughts are influencing on me or any person's or any other's behavior or any other situation or any other circumstances are influencing on me. How I am getting influenced? So in this way, try to observe yourself and steer up. When we direct our thoughts towards positivity, then we understand. Then we develop a positive attitude and this creates ultimately positive reactions. So in this way, by this technique, we can develop positive thoughts in our day-to-day life. So let us understand few positive reflections, how we can produce positive thoughts by our own self. What are the positive thoughts which we are going to reflect every day on ourselves? I am the master of my life. I am special. I am unique person. So I need not compare myself with others. So don't see others' progress because you are unique. You try to progress in your own way. Every day try to improve yourself. Every day we need to break the record of ourselves because always there's a battle. To succeed in life, the battle is between you and yourself only. So therefore, we need not to see others. And I love and I appreciate as I am. Daily, pat on your back. Shabash, very good. In this way, appreciate yourself. And I am the author of my past, present and future. I am the author of my past, my present and my future. I have to bear the fruits of my past actions. And I should be careful and cautious in the present moment. And I have to reap the consequences of my present doings in future. So everything I need is already within me. We have learned from the example of that sculpture, no? So everything is already within me. I am very beautiful within. My experiences are only my power. I am self-reliant and self-determined individual. So therefore, be strong, be different, and be you. The first and foremost thing is always love yourself. I love me. So be strong, be different, and be you. And the golden rule for positive thinking is you have the power to think what you want, no matter whatever the circumstance may be. At every situation, you have the power to think what you want, whatever may be the situation or circumstance, but you have the power to think what you want. So therefore, this is the golden rule to develop positive thinking. Because when we start thinking in a positive way, then definitely we are a living magnet. Because in science, in physics, we have studied about magnetism. According to magnetic rule, unlike poles attract each other, like poles repel each other. So in this, about thought rule here, like thoughts attract each other. So when I do positive thinking, then definitely I attract positive people around me. I attract positive circumstances, events, resources around me. And in the same way, if I do negative thoughts, then definitely I attract negative surroundings around me. So therefore, this our life is like a magnet. So whatever thoughts I produce, I attract the same from the surroundings. So now, if we want to do positive thinking, if we want to develop positive thinking, we need to recharge ourselves daily. So just like we recharge our mobile phones, in the same way, we need to recharge ourselves through meditation. So meditation is a very good practice which helps us to develop positive thinking. So meditation is, in a simple way, meditation is communion of inner light with the supreme light. Antaratma ko Paramatma se connect karna. Ehi meditation hai. So to meditate, we need to understand ourselves from a spiritual perspective. I am not merely this physical being. I am a spiritual being. I possess this physical body. And we need to practice it daily. Through meditation only we are able to develop positive thinking, because meditation is also a positive thinking process. In meditation, we turn ourselves inwards and we start thinking. Through self-realization, we start thinking in a positive way. So now let us do it practically. Are you ready to meditate? So now I request all of you to please sit in a erect position with back straight. Now let us meditate for 3 minutes. Let us understand how to meditate. Now, calm down your thoughts. I'll give you guidelines to meditate, how meditation helps us. So most of the people think that in meditation we need not to do any thoughts, it's a thoughtless stage. But no, here in Brahma Kumari's Raj Yoga meditation, meditation is a positive thinking process, channelizing our thoughts towards positivity, focusing our thoughts towards a higher source and gaining energy from that higher supreme source. That is the principle involved here. Now let us meditate. All of you sit straight and you try to guided thoughts which I am going to give you. Om Shanti. Turn inwards. Distance yourself from the distractions of your mind and thoughts. Create a space from that space on the screen of your mind. Observe your thoughts, how you are generating your thoughts. I am aware of my thoughts. I am positive. I choose pondering over positive thoughts. There is so much of positive energy inherent in me. I am calm. I am peaceful. I hold on to the feelings of peace. I am a peaceful being. I experience the peace within. I am a peaceful being. I radiate the peace in these surroundings. I am a peaceful being. I am peace. I have the power to choose my thoughts. I have the power to choose my responses. I am positive. I am peaceful. Om Shanti. So, in this way, daily if we start our day and end up our day with few positive reflections, just 5 to 10 minutes in the beginning of the day and at the ending of the day, then definitely we can develop positive thinking. We can improve our thinking ability. So we can have positive reflections in our life. So it positive thinking, all of a sudden we can't develop. It needs a lot of practice. It needs a lot of reflections. So therefore, through practice only we can develop positive thinking. So all the things which we have discussed now helps us in developing positive thinking. So therefore, we request all of you, if you want to be a positive thinker, if you want to develop positive thinking, Brahma Kumari's suggestion is daily in the morning, when you wake up, please don't let yourself engaged with WhatsApp, Facebook, with Twitter, Instagram, all these social media or any media that is viewing TV news or reading to newspaper. So instead of that, if you practice at least for 5 to 10 minutes early in the morning when you get up, when you woke up, just 5 to 10 minutes, any positive reflections, if you start doing meditation, then this will help us in a very productive manner to maintain a positive state throughout the day, to control our emotions and to have a balanced lifestyle also. And while going to bed also, before to bed, just for 5 to 10 minutes, have some meditation and reflect on yourself in a positive way. So with this practice, we can definitely develop positive thinking, and we can develop these soft skills in our life, and we can empower our lives. So thank you. I express once again our thanks to Balaji Group of Institutions for conducting such wonderful programs during this corona period and making us also a part of your programs. And I invite all the participants to once go through about Brahma Kumari's organization also. It's a socio-spiritual educational organization spread all over the world in about 147 countries. And this organization aims at betterment of humanity through values, through spiritual knowledge and Raj Yoga meditation. It aims at spiritual awakening and moral upliftment of the society. So thank you. Thank you for being a part of this program. Thank you. Om Shanti.
Thank you. Thank you, madam, for accepting our invitation and for being with us. The session is enlightening and reflected us towards optimism. It's very insightful session and thought-provoking session. Thank you, madam. We have few questions in the chat box, madam. Can we go on with that, madam?
Yeah, okay. Sure.
One person named Chandrasekharan, HOD of English Department, Nagaland. His question is, how should we foster the positive thoughts?
Pardon?
And how should we foster the positive thoughts and how to prepare for the worst?
Yeah. How to foster for positive thoughts means it needs a lot of practice. Just now we have discussed the positive reflections, no? So daily we need to make ourselves understand. Always we should try to look at the brighter side of every situation. We need to ponder over the direct or the indirect advantages of any situation. Maybe sometimes we don't have any advantages or any direct benefits of that situation, but we can console ourselves that I have learned a lesson. We discussed so many examples, lively examples. So in this way, we can console ourselves that I have learned a lesson. Maybe this experience, this incident is like an experience to me. So experiences are like treasures in our life. So this I can store in my memory, store this as an this experience as a treasure. So in this way, we can foster positive thinking. So it needs practice. For this, meditation also helps us in many ways. So we need to daily ponder over positive reflections. So when we start practicing, then definitely we'll get habituated to think in a positive way. And we can, when we are habituated to think in a positive way, then definitely we are possessed with the skills, with the energy to face the worst.
Thank you, madam. One more question from Anu Sharma. The question is, how to come out of the memories of a person who is expired, that's among family members it might be, or like near relatives?
Yeah, okay. So memories, anyhow, our mind is filled with memories. So whatever memories are there in our mind, so will be our mood, so will be our interactions. So therefore, when past memories of sorrowful events, that is death of any near ones, if it is hurting us, if it is very much making us sorrow, then we should try to fill our memories with good events, with the happiest moments of our life. We need to change our memories by filling them with good memories, with happy. If at all there are some mud water in a bucket, so we can remove that mud water in two ways. We can totally pour that mud water out of that bucket, or else if we on the pump, and if we clean water starts flowing, then definitely over a period of time that mud water gets diluted. So in the same way, when we start thinking in a positive way, when we reflect ourselves in a positive way, then slowly, slowly the sorrowful and negative thoughts will vanish from our memory. So it's totally depends on practice.
Thank you, madam. Now I over to our convener of the program, Dr. Narayanan.
Thank you, ma'am, for your nice lecture on soft skills, positive reflections. You covered types of thoughts: ordinary thoughts, positive thoughts, negative thoughts, and waste thoughts. Today, the point which I really inspired, that positive thoughts leads to positive actions. Really, it is a very interesting topic, ma'am. And you covered, when something happened to anybody, immediately they will be influenced or surrounded by negative thoughts. I would like to mention one example happened in this COVID situation. There is a family, father, mother, and two children. Father is earning 10,000 rupees per month. What happened is, working in a school. Suddenly, during this lockdown period, the school management removed him. So he is difficult, he is unable to maintain the family. What happened? He is in debts. Finally, he committed suicide. Now, the mother, she is struggling, to unable to run the family. Finally, she became a maid servant. What happened today, when you are giving illustrations in positive thoughts, positive reflections, immediately I got that incident happened 2 months back because of the negative thoughts. So many people, when something happened, instead of thinking in a positive response, you covered the beautiful point. When something happened, positive response, negative reaction. People quickly, they will react in a negative way. Really, ma'am, I hope all the participants, they have enjoyed the session. And one more thing, I want to tell you that the people I observed, the people who are maintaining spiritual life, I saw that their face is very calm, stress-free, and their face is glowing. Today, I observed in your face, ma'am, really maintaining spiritual life, that maintaining meditation, ultimately, their face is shining, stress-free. Thank you, ma'am, for your nice lecture. Hope all the participants enjoyed. We got so many feedback. Session is informative. Really, they enjoyed a lot. With this, we'll already feedback link posted in the YouTube chat box. Tomorrow, we'll have a last day by Dr. Chandramouli Garu, working as a principal, RMG College, Maharashtra. Tomorrow will be the last session. And today, we'll close this session. I request advisor of our department, Dr. V. Sudhakar Rao Garu, to conclude this session by giving a vote of thanks. Over to Dr. V. Sudhakar Rao Garu.
Yeah, good afternoon all. It's my pleasure to propose a vote of thanks in this program. I hereby express my heartfelt gratitude to Brahma Kumari's Kalpana sister for delivering such a wonderful discourse on soft skills, positive reflections. Madam, really, we were spellbound in the entire session, and it is really very motivating to all the participants. At the outset of the discourse, the clear distinction between soft skills and hard skills was given. And a lot of focus was given on the thoughts of all the positive thoughts and negative thoughts, some cycles of positive thought and negative thoughts were given, and also how to convert our positive thoughts into the negative thought. That is the most important thing for all the participants, and those who think normally negative can have some knowledge from this, and definitely they can change their vision. And all the at the end of that, characters associated with the positive thoughts were clearly explained, and that has given a lot of information to all of us, and with wonderful illustration and example of a teacher, how he changed the negative thoughts of the students into the positive thoughts was given. So everything was excellent, and it was a wonderful examples, illustrations. And at the end of that in the session, we were really happy to have to see you administering the meditation part of that. So now we are aware of how to do the meditation, and really we will utilize that and make our lives very fruitful. So thank you, madam, once again. And I take this opportunity to thank our chairman, Dr. A. Rajendra Prasad Reddy Garu, and our secretary, Dr. G. Rajeshwar Reddy Garu, and our beloved principal, Professor Dr. V.S. Hariharan Garu, and our head of the department, Dr. V. Narayana Garu, coordinators of this program, Mrs. A. Karunasri Garu and S. Srinivas Garu, and other faculty members thanking for coordinating and helping me in this program. Thank you all.
With this, we'll close today's session. From our department, Humanities and Sciences, and from our college, my sincere thanks to today's research person, Sister D.K. Kalpana Garu. Thank you, ma'am. Now,
thank you.
I'll close this session. Thank you, all of you.